Somewhere in the quiet vastness of pre-cosmic space, a mysterious energy, a black, hot force is born out of the blinding whiteness of cosmos in creation. It is the grayness of my soul, smashing through a billion years of seeming, oozing evolution. Primeval mud of my dust-formed body, all the eons of my life, streaks of sullied bone-white, dust-gray, mud-brown, soul-black. Splashed across the cosmic space.
Thank you. You inherit the stench of death. It hovers about the steepest spires and lingers in the liquid pools of incense silence found in private praying places. Come walk with me in the quiet light ways of the Lord of Love, in the vaulted chambers where bloated doves and black cross trees, olive limbs and blood bathed dreams are caught forever in cold mosaics, frozen songs to a phoenix guard. Eli, Eli, Lama Sabachthani, our Holy Father, God of Galilee, Yahweh of Zion, Lord High Executioner, whose righteous wrath forced the rape of his only son. Manna and milk and honey and money, the fat of Canaan have eaten their fill of full-breasted rams and golden-thighed calves. Now they lust for Messiah's blood. O damned of Adam, by Adam damned, have mercy on us. Abraham's nomads, exiles of Egypt, outcasts of Canaan, here is your man. Sanctus, Sanctus, sacred scapegoat. The Hebrew children called out Hosanna to a holy man upon an ass. The hand of God shall smite the heathens. It is a hallowed hand hung by hate, racked the length of pain, pierced to a bitter pulp by a blackened bolt of prophecy. Here is the rapture of redeeming love, slashed to a tree by history's holy hysteria. Ghost of a garden Gethsemane, ghost of a mountain Golgotha, mounted the gibbet of the rood at the sixth hour of the day that was good. My people, what will you have of me? My princely kingdom is not of this world. Caliphs and Caesar may break my bones, but the burden of thorns and the crown of the cross will never, ever harm me. But the trail of my entrails has bloodied all Israel. Eli, Eli, Lama Sabachthani. Dip bread in my blood, you sons of God. My Hebrew feet are not cloven. My Gentile flesh is unleavened. The wound of circumcise is healed. My holy blood is blessed by death. Unless you eat of the broken body and drink of the wine red blood, Lazarus will die again. But Lazarus laughed, Lazarus laughed, Lazarus laughed. It is consummated. There is a hollow place for a dead God, a rock-bound womb wherein he'll rest. Fatted doves will make his tomb of laurel boughs and olive limbs, drenched in sweetest oils and veiled in gentle linens. How silent the tomb of earth. How silent the Hebrew children. How silent the laugh of Lazarus.
Can you see the very textures of the white ocean sand? Can you smell the hot afternoon sun boil rain from the new-cut field? Can you feel the breezes that push the full moon through the mountain evergreens? Can you taste spring give birth to the desert in sudden green? Can you hear the migratory birds pass by in night's black in their north-south formation? Can you see the season-dressed trees change costumes? Can you smell the grinding glacier's slow descent from the mountaintop? Can you feel the waves of heat well up across a planted field drying the golden grain? Can you taste the wind-whipped ocean salt spray upon a friendly cheek? Can you hear in the middle of a humid summer night, corn unfolding to greet a new day? Can you see the white wispy clouds float in high over the land promising a change in tomorrow? Can you smell the first perfume of the wild flowers and know a new season has started? Can you hear the echoing voices of generations out of mind and know that we stand here as a result of them?
our passions into one sweet, spinning, careening sphere. A galaxy of spheres, of sizzling suns and tinsel moons, of shadowed suns and blood-red moons, making horizontal cycles upward through turgid green to black of pavement and oil, to gray brown of steel and concrete, to blinding white of glass and glowing yellow of phosphorescence, to the bloodshed red and gaping black of souls in time and space. Let there be light and heat and energy. Let there be light and heat and energy. Let there be light and heat and energy.
Line creates motion.
Circle evolves sphere.
Angle fashions cube.
Marrow throbs in the heart of bone.
Flesh becomes word.
The electric blood of energy breathes the mystery of cosmic man.
He moves from some unnamed cold infinity, slams against the static finite field, changes the forces of fire and water, of storm and stress,
chaos and anarchy.
It is all fragmented.
Protoplasm splits.
Atoms smash.
Man and cosmos clash.
Until sea water spills over temples.
Dynasties drown in fire.
And planets grow cold in the silence of space.
Man and cosmos clash until time explodes.
In changing eons of fire and ice, in the hope and despair of coming and second coming.
Combat in the multi-sphere.
Survival celebrates life.
To survive.
To live.
To celebrate.
To have touched the mystery of time and space.
To have painted the cosmos.